garlic chill?
I guess.
Pretend we're on the couch.
You didn't do that earlier when we were taking photos. Like, I was like, just relax.
I did. We didn't have a chair. Damn, we should have taken a chair in our photos.
He handed you a chair, and you were like, what do I do with this?
Damn. Love it. Well, hello, NXT Universe. I'm McKenzie Mitchell, and we are doing this new video series where we sit down with some of your favorite NXT superstars, some that you know, some that you don't know, and we just get to chat and talk and see what makes them them. So my first guests, Kacy Catanzaro and Kayden Carter. Welcome, ladies. Thank you for being here. Thanks for having us today.
We're awesome. We're super excited to be here with
you. Good. I'm glad that I get you guys as my first guest. This is fun.
That's like a big deal.
Because we're the first of a lot of things coming to come.
Oh, love it. And we're on the same page. Look, all leather, all black.
Oh, girl, always.
Green, tops of color.
Love that.
Yes.
So you guys are in the first ever.
Always copying me.
We're always saying
you're always saying the same thing as me.
Oh, okay, sisters, get along.
Sometimes I don't even hear that you say it because I said it, and it just cancels it out. And I'm like, did you just say the same thing or what?
This is you guys' friendship, and I think for many of us out there, I myself included, how did you guys begin to become friends? Like, how did you become friends?
Here we go.
You guys are hearing it first.
I mean, I feel like, I always talk about this, I feel like the way the universe was set up, my first match here was a tag with her, so.
This is years ago now. Yeah. Her first match here was a tag with her.
The second we stepped in the ring, we felt like there was like an instant like connection because like, you know, with her background and my background, like I came like from, you know, learning in Mexico and doing like Lucha Strong Style and, you know, her being an American Ninja Warrior and doing gymnastics, like she can do a lot of incredible things. And when you mix those things together, it's like, you know, like creations that like people haven't seen before.
For sure.
Physically in the ring, that was helpful. But then also I feel like that's when we started to realize how much of a normal connection we had and how easy it was to like plan those things, and then how excited we got, and then it was like all these things, and we're like, wait, I like you even outside the ring.
I think, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, she really has my back. You know.
So have you ever butt heads though?
No.
You guys have never had a fight.
No.
And that's true.
Not in the ring or out of the ring. We're so different that we balance each other out like perfectly.
Okay, well, Kayden, I have to ask. I've seen you pulling into the PC several times, and it's literally a car that I would never expect you to drive. It's like this monster truck when you're pulling in. Tell me the story of why you drive this vehicle.
F-150. If they're calling us underdogs or saying as everyone thinks I'm this small person, but like everyone has it twisted. I'm 6'2", 225. Like that's the mentality I have, you know?
Love it.
I love big cars, big trucks, you know? Like that's just like my mindset. I walk in life like I'm taller than everybody else and, you know, just feeling like I'm just a badass.
I see you guys on social media all the time making TikTok videos. I've seen the one of you like under the cover, like how, take me through that, of how that works.
Wait, okay, so we didn't know that everybody would love that one as much. It was a trend and we liked it.
It's just like basically saying when like your friend is going through something, like you're just down for them no matter what, so if she wants to cry under a blanket, like I'm totally there to do it.
Which is so true, that's how it is, you know?
It works because sometimes you don't know what to say, so instead you just put a blanket over yourself and you TikTok together, right?
I love that.
Dance back and forth.
I love that.
Yeah. And everybody needs that. Yeah. You guys are clearly tag team partners in life, but you're also tag team partners in the ring. You guys are in the first ever Women's Dusty Cup. How special is this to you guys?
First ever. I'm getting all pumped up, actually, just thinking about it. I'm like, it's just so big. It's just, since we have been a tag, like, we've always been just itching to get out there. So especially seeing something like the Dusty Cup for the men, we've always been like, man, I wish that we had that. This is finally our time to shine.
Well, to that point, you guys mentioned on Wednesday that people assume that you're the underdogs, or they just say that. Why is that?
People are saying that all the time. That's all I hear all the time. All the time. Oh, you're such an underdog. Which, like,
and why,
to
why
be
is
fair,
that?
Well, for me, it's because I'm small, I'm assuming.
And because
I smile.
Small but mighty.
And because I smile all the time, I guess, maybe. I mean, look at our first round against Toni and Mercedes. They've been wrestling probably over 2 decades put together compared to 5 years of us.
Oh, yeah. Right. Are you nervous at all?
Honestly, like, I'm not afraid to wrestle them. I'm actually excited. You know, they are talked about as some of the best in the world, and the fact that that's our first competitor when we advance, you know, that's saying a lot about us. Sure. You know, like, that's saying, like, what we have to offer and, like, what we're capable of, and then that really should put a fear to everyone else who, like, you know, may end up, like, facing us in the second round.
See us as the underdogs, like, we're ready to come in there and show everybody what we got.
Well, I love that mentality.
Yeah.
It's cool seeing you guys break barriers. That's awesome. So, keep it up. Love you guys. And thanks again.
Oh, thank you.
Best of luck in the Women's Dusty Cup.
Thank you.